Are you going to convert the dream into reality? Then I told that you are converting the reality into dream by your non-cooperation, by lack of your integrity. Now you have to give this security your real status. Its real status is reality. Then who are the hindering persons? The terrorism has different types. Security is also of different types. Certainly there is your research work which is going to take place now. Number one, in chillness you are wearing a sweater. That is also a security tool. But that is not a security tool for bullet. For bulletproof there is something different. For fireproof there is something different. Waterproof there is something different. So security, the level of security, the object of security, the measure of security, grade of security, that is contextual, personal, temporal. It is based on the dimensions of persons, values, contextual emulsions, the person's vulnerability as well as the velocity of the intrusion vector. The vectors of intrusion, they are having velocity. And the receptacles of that velocity, they are having their vulnerability. Based on the velocity, vulnerability, along with the tri-dimensional evaluation of time, place, and contextual circumstances, we have to evaluate what is security. And also, the various other factors which we have to consider are, there are a lot of people who are giving insecurity within the family. That is domestic insecurity. Like domestic violence, that is there. Then social, that of lot of social insecurity due to linguistic barriers, religious barriers, there are lot of other various things. No doubt they are not directly going to attack and create a very great calamity, but that will deroute the people in attending to security issues and preparing themselves for attacking or counter-attacking these things. So there are two harms. Directly contributing calamity is also calamitous. That is preventing the people from being prepared for waging a war against calamity, it is diluting the strength. We need three things. One, we need strength. We need attention. We need integrity. The strength is diluted. The integrity is disintegrated. Our attention is diverted towards petty issues. Economical issues, social issues, linguistic issues. Innumerable issues are there. They pave the way that we don't think about what we need really. So there are attention diluters, energy diluters and integrity diluters. There are hundreds of such things. They are the real reasons. They are the real reasons for insecurity rather than the terrorists. There are smugglers, there are rowdies, there are disruptive persons, there are persons engaged in immoral trafficking, there are extremists, there are separatists, they are fundamentalists. Innumerable persons are there in various areas working for that. And terrorists are the persons interested in doing a very great thing. Terrorists have crossed, they have been petrified. They have been totally petrified, made into wood and stone. They don't have any feelings at all. Unless the directed direction or principle of a genocide, mass annihilation, they don't have any other feeling at all. They don't have any other feeling. They have been specially incubated, injected, instilled and inculcated for the purpose. They don't have anything at all. They are specially designed, created enzymes and structures. So to tackle them, we must have similar strength and prowess in our side, which is not there. First of all, where is the place and person of attack? There are two things. One is targeted, second is untargeted. Or we can say that is a general target or common target or specific target. If somebody is against you, then targeting on you is personal specific target. You are not my target. Common people, I have to disturb the social harmony. I have to disturb your security. I have to disturb the national integration or the national functionary. So common people totally, I'm going to annihilate the people. That is targeted, common, personal attack. Then place is also like that. If you start a good company, you will start at a place where people will come and purchase for construction. For destruction also, where people will assemble like railway stations, the public parks, public malls, where people they used to conglomerate, from there only they will do that. That is a place. So we know whom they will attack. We know when they will attack also. When they will attack, can you do some astrological predictions or something? No, we can clearly understand by socio-psychological impressions and historical records and possibilistic logical interface studies. We can easily understand that. One, reminder, whenever something has occurred before, on the same day, they could have the same vengeance or vehemence and they can do that. Like the famous December 6th. It is something connected with resemblant attack based on reminder theory. Second thing is counter attack. If somebody connected to them, based on them, part and parcel of them, if they are either captivated, if they are executed, or if they are tried, if they are arrested, if they are annihilated, if they are subjected to any sort of a problem, immediately it will have a counter impact there. There is a common impact. Whenever commonly, not personally to people, whenever commonly something happens somewhere which is disturbing to them, immediately they will do like that. So these are all some areas where they will reflect all of these things. And what is the purpose of these terrorists? Purpose of the terrorists is just to demand. What they demand? They demand a place, they may demand a policy, they may demand some persons. When the aircraft was hijacked, they demanded people. Regarding the Kashmir issue, they are demanding a place. In other places, they are demanding policies for protest. So policy, place or persons are demanded. It is a continuous journey. It is a continuous effort. It is a penance and austerity of terrorists in which continuously they are engaged in that. So to do a thing, immediately we know that if you want to organize a seminar, we need manpower, we need technical resources, and we need finance. And we have to beg lot of people, we have to surrender to lot of people, we have to ask from lot of people, request, beseech, threaten, innumerable things we have to do within the possible means, ethical means. For the terrorists, they are having wonderful resources. Well, how it is possible? Because of two reasons. All the other non-terrorists, all the other normal citizens of the country, they have lot of works. They are all classified, like doctors, auditors, then accountants, then advocates, then engineers, they are all classified. Terrorists, they have no classification at all. They are all terrorists. As we are being put into various faculties, we cannot concentrate on that. We have domestic, physical, emotional, mental, financial, social, cultural, moral, political, spiritual, innumerable dimensions. These people, they have only economical, political, and their personal terrorist ideologies and methodologies. They don't have anything at all. Government, it is having a lot of projects, like rural development, financial development or economical empowerment of the nation, then development of agriculture, food security and irrigation for the society. They have to deal with women empowerment, child care, health and hygiene of the country, defense mechanism and internal security of the system. It has to deal with the tribal welfare, it has to do with the science and technology. So innumerable issues are there before the government. Terrorists, they don't have any issues at all. As terrorists, they don't have any issues of commitment or responsibility. As they don't have any other job to do, they are fully focused on, they are totally dedicated. That's what I used to say in my seminars. I have attended and organized a lot of seminars on terrorism. Terrorism is nothing but patriotism misplaced. All qualities of us, they are very finely located, are embellished in the terrorists. They are fully concentrated on all these things. How they are getting financial resources? Number one, smuggling. Number two, mischief technology. They are organizing lot of coolie works for various industries or government organizations or international agencies by which they get money. Then there are lot of secret and intelligent clandestine supporters within the same society, those who are giving them funds. They are funded by international agencies, either religious agency, political agencies, or international intelligence idiotic agencies. They are not known as intelligent agencies, they are idiotic agencies. They are funding a lot of people to debilitate the standards of nation by which they can get inside and rule to have domination. There are two things. I want to dominate everybody. I want to exploit everybody. If they are having something, I want to exploit. After getting something, I want to dominate. These are all the two wishes of human psychology, which is reflecting in this thing also. Then how they are getting manpower? You see, that's what I told you in one seminar. If I want to make you a patriot, even if I teach you for 5 years, you will rub your ears and you will go to your home and continue what you have been doing. But terrorists, for transformation, within a week he can bring the transformation. A patriot, because for the patriot or the so-called reformers of the society, it comes from their lips, whereas from terrorists, it comes from their brain and mind. It is a synchronized integral dictation system by which they are making the dictatorship very vehemently, very processively and very systematically. That thing is not with the patriotism. Because the methodology of implementation of or installation of the doctrines of terrorism, they are well organized. And this thing is not well organized. So what they are doing? Vehemence injection. By means of three things, three Ds. One is a drug. There are also a lot of chemicals which makes you to have a stubborn and staunch feeling and to make yourself very rigid and non-flexible to any grounds, no possibility of conversion, change, dilution or hyper-specification, that much of drugs are injected, then demo is being done, a very great oral command, what is my oratory and what is my elocution? Their elocution is very wonderful. If Osama Bin Laden speaks here, immediately if I speak and if I just go out, everybody will go for lunch. If Osama Bin Laden speaks here, everybody will go for lunch, but with Osama Bin Laden at Afghanistan or Pakistan. That is... That